got 90 cues to record in 2.5 days. And it does seem like a bit of a mountain.
I'm scared.
Are you scared?
I'm scared.
You don't have any faith.
All right, here we are.
The score for an ambitious new documentary is being recorded live at the concert hall. And here to talk about it is documentarian and anthropologist Niobe Thompson.
We're telling the story of us, of our human species. As we were making this film, we could see that the majesty of the images, the kind of images we were using, needed to be answered by a big sound, a full sound, a rich sound. And so we really made it a priority to make this a live recorded orchestral score.
There's minimal rehearsal for film scores. They get the music, they sit down with their instrument, and they're reading it for the first time when the conductor starts conducting.
The musicians, they needed to have the confidence that there was someone standing in front of them who could lead them.
I tried to suck in my gut, so it doesn't look so big on camera.
Darren's fast. He's fast, he's funny, he's crisp.
We went through a lot of papers.
Many trees died because of this project.
He really appreciates musicians that he works with.
Sounding great, Liam. Thank you. I know all you strings love these flat keys. I know you're just in love with them all.
As a film composer, he's expected not only to write the music, to create the music, but also to conduct.
Good. Do you guys have any places you guys want to punch in there, Jeremy? Any comments, thoughts?
I'd like one more take. Maybe we could punch in 2 before 14.
Okay.
What we're doing in this room is all 4 of us are having a different role. You know, I'm basically just operating Pro Tools, which is the click and the video, and making sure that that everyone's hearing what they need to hear. But because I'm doing that, I can't watch the score to make sure that someone's not playing a wrong note. Jeremy's listening for pops and clicks. He's making sure that sonically that all of our microphones are working okay, that the balance is okay.
I'm an extra set of ears just to help out with our producers. And Vincent is the orchestrator, and so if there's anything that needs to be fixed on the fly.
It happens.
During my career, there were very few orchestras that did any kind of film score recording at all. It just simply wasn't affordable. It wasn't possible.
Typically today, what you would do with a project like this is you would offshore the recording. So you'd take it to Prague or you'd take it to Beijing, where you can do this kind of work much more cheaply. But it was really important for us to do this with our own musicians. And we even have Darren Fung, the composer and conductor, who was born and raised in Edmonton, coming back from LA to do this with us. From the very beginning, this was a made in Edmonton project. The cinematographers, the editing team, the post-production, I myself, we're all from Edmonton. And so when we knew we were doing a symphonic score, we wanted to bring it back to our city.
Well, I wouldn't have recognized you, you know, now if I saw you down the street. But
You
looked a little different as 5-year-old.
You know? I did. I was a little pudgier.
That's right.
I had blonde hair.
Yeah, that's right. Good to see you.
Yeah, good to see you.
Congratulations.
Thanks.
my old music teacher.
An orchestra is a magical human construct. What I hear when I hear the score is tenacity in the strings, courage, the brass, the sensitivity, and the piano and the harp. And the woodwinds just soar above it all. Some people say that film scores that are most successful are the ones that you don't consciously hear, but that influence you and impact you and engage you emotionally with what's going on visually.
First time working with a choir in a film score, recording with a choir, and I have to say, it's such a treat. You guys sound remarkable in this wonderful space. It's really lovely, so thank you so much for that. Don't fuck up.
Right now we're doing the percussion overdub, so these are all sounds that will get layered onto the main score. So we're just moving through the gongs and the marimbas and the cymbals, and we'll see how it goes. It's fun.
When you're working on a film budget and a film timeline, speed is of the essence.
Do you think you can get this up and going in 20 minutes?
In 20 minutes?
No, it's 10 minutes now.
Darren knew exactly where he was, where his time was, and he knew when things had to speed up and when he could sort of sit back and let an artistic moment evolve.
This is an incredibly ambitious amount of music. Like, the LA standard of recording music is 5 minutes to an hour. So that really, we should have been able to record 57 minutes of music. And we're already at 76, 77
minutes. We've got to get to 83 or something like
80,
that.
80, yeah.
I think that by the middle of today, the time is going to have worn on these players. They're working hard, and they're laying down track after track, sight reading. I mean, it's just exhaustion. Exhaustion is what I'm worried about.
The brain just starts to go.
Sorry, stand by. You guys can't walk around when we're about to record.
I think the most tiring part of it is, like, you have to be really quiet.
We cannot do anything until I put my hands down, like pencil marks or anything like that, because that's going to affect the recording. Overtime frenzy!
Just ran out of time, and so we're going to work into overtime. But I mean, all things considered, we've done an incredible amount of music in very little time. We're very close to the end. Another half an hour, and the orchestra is finished.
I need a drink.
Many orchestras are starting to think about what's next.
There seems to be this great appetite to come to this concert hall, hear the symphony orchestra, watch one of your favorite motion pictures, and see the music being performed live. You're sort of letting the audience into the magician's tricks. You know, they get to see the music coming to life right before them.
This is the moment of the birth of our musical score.
Changing planet, forged in Africa, but also driven.
stand.
I think Darren has written a magnificent score. It's bold, it's lyrical, it's introspective, it has moments of mystery, it has moments of grandeur, it celebrates life.
To me, it's a feat of engineering, it's a feat of technology, it's a feat of artistry.
When it all clicks together, it's magic.
You know, it's an amazing homecoming for me to come back to work with musicians here in Edmonton.
It seemed to me like you were playing with the same tightness and energy and delicacy and sensitivity right to the last moment. It is such a pleasure to work with professionals like you.
This project has worked so successfully because of the spirit of the orchestra, the generosity in being able to go in blind. That's where the conductor's role comes in, to make sure this entire beast is coordinated properly. So I think when you get all those elements working well together, then you have an orchestra that can do a film score really well.
Can you hum the main theme?
I'd rather not. We're hiring singers.
You wrote it. Come
we're hiring singers.
I can't remember it.
Really?
Really? It's not drilled into my brain.